I spill it with an F of Fashion Squared here at the Macho Super launch of his spring summer collection, Chernobyl. And tonight promises to be just like Chernobyl. It's going to go off with a big bang. I'm here with the man of the hour, well, the man of the night. It's Mr. Macho Subart, larger than life, here in person. Tell me, how was tonight for you?
Amazing. It couldn't get any better. It was, yeah, absolutely fantastic. Like, I don't know what to say. I'm actually quite sad it's over. I'm really over Melbourne. I'm just like, I love, like, people flew to Melbourne from all over Australia, and like, it's incredible. Like, I couldn't ask for anything better or more. It's amazing.
Girls, what were your style picks from tonight's show?
Definitely the two-tone leather.
Definitely.
Lots of studs, lots of gold on leather as well.
Must have taken quite a skill to combine elegance with like a dead baby's arm around your neck. Amazing.
I didn't see the dead baby's arm. Where was that?
There were a few bit like doll's arms like that floating around or something like that. Combined like around necklaces and things like that.
Now, someone told me tonight that a dead baby's arm is the latest accessory.
Chernobyl's neck. Yes, it is. It's the must-have accessory for the season.
Where would you be sporting one?
Children's prosthetics. That's all we like.
We are in the post-postmodern world. I do think dead babies' arms are probably the next chic fashion accessory. Don't
add them with gas masks and like and gas containers or something. Yeah.
Where would I be sporting one? Look, it's not my thing, but I'm all for it.
Well, I think it's always good to have one hanging around your neck. You never know when you're going to need it.
You might need to jam a door open or something like that.
Right,
you know,
right.
Break your way out of a taxi after a long night out.
Yeah. KFC is not the perfect hangover cure. Did we see any Pripyat babies in the show tonight?
There were a few Pripyat babies on the heads, in the background, on the necks. So, yeah, this is just a little fun, something macho in the collection. Just a little hands and arms and little legs and head. Yeah.
Macho knows accessories, and he knows, like, even though he's doing something a bit more that he finds conservative, he's still all out there in the accessories, like the nails and everything. It's just all in the details.
Telling me how you've taken Chernobyl, one of the biggest disasters in the world's history, and turned it into high fashion. How did you do that?
You tell me, I'm not sure.
Now, did you find the whole presentation quite theatrical?
Very, very theatrical. It was good to really get involved in the show and really get a feel of his collection.
Very entertaining. Very entertaining.
It was amazing. It was totally macho. Like, everything. I actually met up with him like 2.5 weeks ago, and I was like, tell me what you're doing. He goes, well, I'm going to keep it a surprise. I'm doing something a bit more conservative. That's all I'm going to say. And then I saw it tonight. I was like, this is definitely conservative macho.
So you're telling me that Chernobyl, one of the world's most notorious disasters, was conservative for macho?
Oh, definitely.
Like, people think I'm creating all those collections to steer the waters, make a reaction, get the people to talk about it, kind of like get people to get angry. But there's a really deep meaning behind all the collections I create, such as last one and this one. So it's really personal, I would say, because where I'm coming from, no, where I was born and where I come from. So, yeah, the question is very personal. It's kind of like letting people know what actually Chernobyl is, because before, when I was creating the collection, all the process, half of the people I asked about Chernobyl, they had no idea what Chernobyl was. So the collection is kind of like sending a message across and kind of like a momentum, like, hey guys, this thing shit happened 20 something years ago, still happening, still there, know about it.
Oh, Noble mean to you?
A city that was completely bombed and nuclear, everything.
Yeah, I was almost going to say Rise of the Dead, really sort of deep underground sort of stuff.
Very confronting.
You didn't go with the theme though. Where's your piece of Chernobyl?
I don't know. Maybe my ear piercing. I don't know.
The piercing, yeah. Straight through this.
That's as studded as it gets for me.
Except for that special limb you might be missing. Now show me this bling on the nails. What is going on? Can you see that? Can you see that? What is this? What is this?
Just a little touch from my that I got from models. You know, just a bit of a.
Do you have a shade that will match my bling?
Not on me, but yeah.
Maybe we can go for a manicure later together.
Yeah, we can. Yeah.
Manicure, pedicure.
Sounds good to me.
I need to be cured of a few things. All in one. All right.
Sounds good.
All right. It's a date. Word.
No.